You want me to hunt down the people who killed her?
This is where it gets complicated. Last week, I received a message with her voice on it. Dahlia is alive.
Niin, nyt on saunassa käyty ja hyvä olo. Hyvä aika jatkaa peliä. Okei, mulla on täällä näin. Tarkastetaan volyymin taso. Kuuluuko mitään? Se on hyvä, kun tuossa on vararuutu, niin voi katsoa, että mitä. Mitä sieltä oikeesti tulee, miltä se näyttää mulla on. Vähän säätämistä ton chatin kanssa muun muassa, mutta pärjäällään tässä. Hyvät fiilikset on ollut tästä pelistä kyllä siis tähän mennessä.
Oh, how did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
We blasted through with the mining laser.
No niinpä tietysti.
Yes, that makes sense.
Ihmiset on aina räjäyttelemässä kaikkea.
Any idea how we get out of this place? There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on.
Nyt se näyttää hissiltä ja toimii kuten hissi, niin se on todennäköisesti hissi.
Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Mistä te hirveän hyvissä väleissä etenet kanssa?
He probably wants you to help him find it.
The conduit, but I don't know.
Jos on matriarkka, niin sehän on niinku 700 000 vuotta vanha äiti. Eli Liara on oikeesti niinku iltatähti.
We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander, secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
He needs to move faster.
Jaha. Ja meillä on hardcore-moodi tällä hetkellä päällä.
Brenda, or don't. That would be more fun.
We don't have time to deal with this idiot. Charge!
I like your attitude.
Ensinnäkin se voisi tulla ampumatta. Ei, kun hetkinen. Sitten toinen sun. Toi voisikaa vaihtaa puolta. Biotiikkaa ei varmaan oo. Enää meidän puolella. Okei, nyt se on yhtiön näköinen. Molemmat on kippuun nyt heti. No on ikäviä, jos ne pääsee lähelle noin Kroganin se poistui. Tai siis hajosi toi suojakenttä. Se tarkoittaa sitä, että koko paikka tulee alas, joten niinku... No. Tää on sinematiikka, että ne ei voi kuolla tässä. Yleinen niinku viisaus. Viidakon sananlasku. Ilmanpaine tuli pihalle. Separdilla huono kunto.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
Sometimes Joker's a real ass. Just try to ignore him.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander.
Miera on sillä juuri täytin 18 vuotta.
You saved my life back there. And not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
Just how old are you exactly?
I hate to admit it, but I am only 106.
Damn! I hope I look that good when I'm your age.
A century may seem like a long time to a short-lived species like yours. But among the Asari, I am barely considered more than a child. That is why my research has not received the attention it deserves. Because of my youth, other Asari scholars tend to dismiss my theories on what happened to the Protheans.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved.
Mm.
It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge. Patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right. And eventually, I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
What cycle? What are you talking about?
The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
You're not much of an expert, Doctor. The answer's been standing in front of you the whole time. The Protheans were wiped out by a race of machines, the Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear.
Ihmekään, että oli vähän
painajasta varaa. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process.
You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
This isn't helping us find Saren or the Conduit.
Of course, you're right.
Keidan on vähän.
I'm sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Uh-huh. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the Conduit or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Rex on ihan oikeassa. Create another alien.
We've already got every other non-human species on board. Might as well add an Asari to the team.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful.
Volus ja Elkor puuttuu vielä kyllä.
I am afraid I am feeling lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion, coupled with the shock of discovering the Protheans' true fate. I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Liara is on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Hmm.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
We almost died in there. The Geth were everywhere.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all
counting. Turiani jatkuvasti epäilee Shepardia. Ei tykkää ihmisistä ilmeisesti.
I prefer gold to silver, you know, for my metal. I figured you'd recommend me for one since I pulled your boots out of the fire.
Saving my boots from burning lava is part of your job, Joker. We don't give medals to soldiers for doing their jobs.
That figures. Just get me a nice card and a cake. No coconut, though. I hate that crap. So, Commander,
why don't you go?
How's the Normandy performing? Is she everything they said she'd be?
She's the best ship in the fleet. If you've got a pilot who knows how to handle her. Balance isn't what you'd expect. It takes a while to get used to that oversized drive core we got stuffed in the back, and a power can sneak up on you if you're not careful. The Normandy's probably too much ship for your average Alliance pilot, Commander. Lucky for you, I'm anything but average.
I like to know my crew. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
I can see where this is going. You did a background check on me, didn't you? Well, I'll tell you the same thing I told the captain. You want me as your pilot. I'm not good. I'm not even great. I am the best damn helmsman in the Alliance fleet. Top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those commendations in my file, I earned every single one. Those weren't given to me as charity for my disease.
I can't have you on this ship if you're going to infect my crew.
Oh man, you have no idea what I'm talking about, do you?
Okay, I've got full syndrome.
Brittle bone disease. The bones in my legs never develop properly. They're basically hollow. Too much force and they'll shatter. Even with crutches and my leg braces, it's hard to get around. One wrong step and crack! It's very dramatic. But I've learned to manage my condition, Commander. Put the Normandy in my hands and I'll make her dance for you. Just don't ask me to get up and dance unless, you know, you like the sound of snapping shin bones.
Why does everyone call you Joker?
It's a lot shorter than saying Alliance Flight Lieutenant Jeff Moreau. Plus, I love to make little children laugh.
I was just thinking how much you remind me of Santa Claus.
Look, I didn't pick the name. One of the instructors in flight school used to bug me about never smiling. She started calling me Joker, and it stuck.
Why didn't you ever smile?
Hey, I worked my ass off in flight school, Commander. The world's not gonna hand you anything if you go around grinning like an idiot. By the end of the year, I was the best pilot in the academy. Even better than the instructors, and everybody knew it. They'd all got their asses kicked by the sickly kid with the creaky little legs. One guess who was smiling at graduation?
I have to go.
Alright, see ya.
Seth Green, ääninäyttelijä. Tässä pelissä on itse asiassa aika paljon niin kuin kovamaineisia ääninäyttelijöitä. Ja nyt mä arvaan, että mitä kaikki ajattelee. Täytyy käydä juttelemassa ihmisten kanssa.
Commander, do you have a minute?
I always make time for my officers.
Off the record, I think there's something wrong here. This Saren is looking for records on some kind of galactic extinction, but we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
The Council doesn't want to believe anything's wrong. I'd call it human nature, but...
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long
as the Council should see this coming. Neuvoston pitäisi tietää.
And the residents don't even seem impressed by the view or the dangers.
Well, well, you're a romantic. Did you sign on for the dream, Malenko? Secure a man's future in space?
Yeah, I read a lot of those books when I was a kid, where the hero goes to space to prove himself worthy of a woman he loves, or, you know, for justice. Or maybe I was a romantic in the beginning, but I thought about it after brain camp. Biotic acclimation and temperance training.
Kuulostaa pahalta.
I just want to do some good. See what's out here. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
Tell me about it.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, Alden is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be
combined.
There are worse results of accidental exposure to element zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Is there some question about how you were exposed?
My mother was downwind of a transport crash. It was before there were human biotics, a little after the discovery of the Martian ruins. It only gets iffy around 63 when Kinetics was running out of first-gen subjects. Until then, they'd relied on accidentals. A bunch of guys in suits show up at your door after school, and next thing you know, you're out on Jump Zero.
Jump Zero is Gagarin Station, right? What's it like?
Yeah, that's the official name. Biggest and farthest facility we had for decades. Right on the termination shock, the outer edge of the solar system.
It's where they did all the
Chase FTL research before we caught on to using mass effect fields. It was a sterile research platform when I was there.
There were other kids in the same boat, right? At least you weren't alone out there.
That's true. We did have a little circle that'd get together every night before lights out. We didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then, and Kinetics kept Jump Zero off the extranet to prevent leaks.
You know of any intentional exposures for certain?
No one knows. Doesn't mean they didn't happen. As big as the exposures were, it was hard to track down accidentals. It was different then. No one knew the potential, so there wasn't a lot of regulation. Anything Kinetics did was gold. I'm not saying they intentionally detonated drives over our outposts, but in retrospect, they were damn quick on the scene.
Do you know of any intentional exposures for certain?
No one knows. Doesn't mean they didn't happen. It was different then. I'm not saying they intentionally detonated drives over our outposts, but in retrospect, we didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then.
You were all teenagers. I'm sure you found other ways to occupy your time.
Eikö tuolla ole seksuaalista häirintää?
Not lightly, anyway. There was a girl I spent a lot of time with, but we kept our clothes on. Rana. She was from Turkey. Her family was very rich. But she was smart and charming as hell. Beautiful I'm not stuck up about it. Like you, I guess. Well,
sounds like she was special to you.
She was. Maybe she felt the same. But things never felt together. Training, you know.
Jump Zero's a long way from home. What was it like?
The grand gateway to humanity looks a lot better in the vids. Anyway, this was supposed to be a casual debrief, not a bull session about stuff that happened years ago.
I wanted to get to know you a little better, that's all. Thanks for the talk, Caden.
Well, you're welcome, ma'am. You make a habit of getting this personal with everyone?
No, I don't. We'll talk again later.
I'll need some time to process that, Commander. But, yeah, I'd like that.
Yeah, putki aivokunnolla. No, tää on taas jotain romua. Mä ehkä mieluummin otan tarkemman rynnäkkökiväärin kuin vahinkoa tekevän, koska... Koska... Itse asiassa ole juurikaan huonompi. Tarvin kyllä uuden panssarin täällä.
Yes, Commander. Is there something you need?
How did you end up serving on an alliance ship?
Tässä on nyt on pimeä kuva. Jostain syystä tuolla ei ole valoja tuossa medikaalissa hirveästi.
I figured the colonies were teeming with exotic adventure. I wanted to travel the stars, tending the wounds of tough soldiers with piercing eyes and sensitive souls. Turns out military life isn't quite as romantic as I'd imagined. Yeah. Humanity needs the Alliance if we want to keep expanding through the Traverse. And the Alliance always needs good doctors. So I stayed on to do my part.
Ever think you made the wrong choice?
Sometimes I think about opening a private practice back on Earth. Or maybe taking a position at one of the new med centers out in the colonies. But there's something special about working on soldiers. If I left the Alliance now, I'd feel like I was abandoning them.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Nyt tässä on valaistus.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
Alliance medical personnel take courses in alien biology, just in case.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from the Geth, Commander. If you hadn't shown up...
I'm just glad we got there in time.
So am I. I know you took a chance bringing me aboard this ship. I have seen the way your crew looks at me. They do not trust me. But I am not like Benezia. I will do whatever I can to help you stop Saren. I promise.
Don't worry, Liara. I trust you. I know you won't let me down.
It means a lot to hear you say that, Commander. Thank you.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
I don't understand it. She was always outspoken about the need for the Asari to become more involved in shaping galactic events.
Tää on ihan sitä varmasti.
Would somehow be for the greater good in the long run. At least I hope so.
This hurts you, doesn't it?
None of this makes any sense to me. I have not spoken to Benezia in many years, but I know her. And this was not like her. Something changed.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning
for us. Niin, näillä on yksi sukupuoli tällä
we still require a partner to reproduce.
Partenogeneesillä lisääntyy.
Parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term. Not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be
involved. Käyttää avaruusmagiaa.
It is not an essential element of the union. The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different. Some unions are a single encounter with both parents parting ways afterwards. Others can be more long-term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
You Asari live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner dies?
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander. I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Tell me about yourself, Liara.
No, kysytään tässä saman tien kaikki.
I am afraid I am not very interesting, Commander. I spend most of my time on remote digs, unearthing mundane items buried in long-forgotten Prothean ruins.
You must enjoy something about it.
I love my work. Seeking out history's lost secrets has a special appeal for me. You were actually touched by working Prothean technology. That is why I find you so fascinating, Commander.
Sounds like you want to dissect me in a lab somewhere.
What? No! I did not mean to insinuate. I never meant to offend you, Shepard. I only meant that you would be an interesting specimen for an in-depth study. No, that's even worse.
Calm down, Liara. I was only joking.
Joking? Oh, by the goddess! How could I be so dense? You must think I am a complete and utter fool. Now you know why I prefer to spend my time in the field with data disks and computers. I always seem to say something embarrassing around other people. Please, just pretend this conversation never happened.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Täällä on ihan hyvä pyssy. Tässä oli Liarakin taitaa synnäkkökiväärällä tässä pelin versiossa pärjätä parhaiten. Se ei taida mitään bonusta saada pistooleihin ja muihin tämmöisiin näihin. Periaatteessa ei kannata antaakaan sitten sille niitä.
Commander?
Do you have a few minutes?
Sure. I was hoping to get a minute of your time. Off the record.
I keep an open door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
You don't trust their motives because they're not human.
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons.
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We, humanity, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies.
Niin tämähän on nyt pelin keskeinen teema itse asiassa.
If their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
Et niin kuin yhteistyö erilaisten olentojen välillä. Tämähän on se teema, mitä niin kuin, mikä pyörii itsensä jatkuvasti tässä näin, niin kuin tämän pelisarjan kohdalla. Ja niin kuin, sitten kun alkaa, no kolmasessa ala menee asiat todella vaikeaksi, niin sitä on hyvin vaikeaa saada sitä yhteistä liittoumaa kasaan.
Yeah, the Council's had a grudge against us since the first contact war.
I don't think it's a grudge. I think it's... Look. If you're fighting a bear, and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always
mitä muuta se on kuin rasismia?
You sound like one of those Terra Firma party pamphlets, Chief.
Terra Firma is a pack of jackals. The founders had ideals. These days they just play off xenophobia and bigotry. I hope my reasons are more rational. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
Just shut up.
It doesn't sound like you've worked with aliens before.
No, ma'am. Mainly I've been groundside, part of the surface garrison forces. I did get a rotation on a space station for training. Every Marine a rifleman, every rifleman ZG certified.
That's odd. Your record is spotless and your technical scores are exemplary. You should be serving with the fleet.
Anyway, that's why I haven't served with many aliens, Commander.
I come from a military family too. My parents were both Navy. Anybody in your family we might know?
Couldn't say, Commander. We probably have a lot in common. You join up to carry on the tradition?
Mainly I wanted to serve. Protect the Alliance, save lives, you know?
Glad to hear it. I'd hate to think you were out here for a free college education.
Niin kuin Jenkeisessä on niin kuin... mä oon kysellyt jo.
Alright, I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission.
Tää ei itse asiassa kertonut Ashley koko sen tarina.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
I'm glad there won't be a problem.
Anything else you need, Commander?
What's your opinion of the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I think she's being straight with us. Or at least I don't think she lies very often.
Yeah,
she's probably really bad at it. Hey, want me to ask her about her sex life? Might be illuminating.
I don't think she's used to teasing, good natured or otherwise.
No fun, Commander.
Niinpä.
Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Commander, how are you?
I gotta go.
Commander.
No.
Commander, how are you?
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
That's tough. But you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate. me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits.
I could have received some training,
but my father didn't like it. He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
Spoken like a true CSEC officer.
Yeah, it's a speech I've heard one too many times. But Saren's not going to play by our rules, CSEC's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
You're a quick learner, Garrus. We'll beat him at his own game. It's the only way to stop someone like him.
I'm right behind you, Commander. Looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Tämä voisi olla ihan hyvä panssari, mutta mulla ei ole. Rahaa hirveesti. Toksiksiilejä ei tässä tarvinnut käytännössä koskaan. Kaikki ykköstason kamat voi yksinkertaisesti heittää vaan pois, paitsi chemical roundsit, koska... Ja heatsinkkikin on ihan ok. Edelleenkään ei ole. Tarvii rahaa. Rahia.
Flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just the silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, kind of miss them.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have till it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them. But maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually. But we have to stop Saren first.
Sitten katsoi sellainen kysymys, että mistä hän tehtävästä me lähettäisiin seuraavaksi. Mitä seuraavaksi tekemään, jos muistatte Mass Effectin pelejä, niin ensimmäistä peliä, niin mä voisin kysellä tästä vähän lisää.
Our lives aren't easy. Resources are scarce. And we are constantly on the move. Everything we do must in some way contribute to the continuation of the migrant fleet. There are 17 million Quarians in the flotilla, and each of us relies on the others for survival. The bonds among my people are strong.
17 miljoonaa Quariania.
We have had to surrender many of the freedoms and civil liberties other species take for granted.
What kind of freedoms?
Well, it's illegal for parents to have more than one child. If our population grows too much, it would strain our resources to their breaking point.
Eli kaikki lapset ovat hemmoteltuja.
Of course, we also can't allow our numbers to become too few. If our population is in decline, the rule against single births is temporarily repealed. In extreme cases of population decline, incentives are even offered to encourage multiple births. Though the Conclave hasn't had to take such measures in nearly a century.
That's your government.
The Conclave is our civilian branch of government. Each ship can elect a representative to serve on the Conclave and make decisions that affect the fleet as a whole. On matters that affect an individual ship, however, the captain has the final say. It's a tradition that dates back to the early days, when the fleet was governed by martial law. Fortunately, most captains nowadays are smart enough to have an elected council from their crew to give them advice and guidance.
So the ultimate power rests with elected officials?
In practice, the Conclave and the respective council for each ship tend to set the rules that govern our daily lives.
Tähän oli aika hyvä. Tähän aika hyvä lore, mikä tähän on kirjoitettu. Vähän ensimmäiseen peliin jo. Eli tämän takia niin kuin myöskin niin kuin ihmiset odottaisivat, että tulisi niin kuin jatkoa Mass Effect-peleille, koska tämä on ihan mielenkiintoinen tota noin niin kuin universumi.
It's a safeguard that served us well. In nearly three centuries, the Admiralty Board has only overruled the Conclave four times.
I want to know more about the Geth.
I doubt I can tell you anything you don't already know. It's been almost three centuries since they drove my people into exile. All I know is the story of their origins. What they were when we created them, and how they turned on us.
Interesting.
The Geth were originally created to serve as an automated manual labor force. Initially, their intelligence was as limited as any VI. Over time, we made small modifications to their programming to allow them to perform more varied and complex tasks, bringing them closer and closer to true AI status.
How come the Council didn't step in and stop you?
This wasn't true AI research. We may have been skirting the bounds of the law, but we never did anything that was actually illegal. The changes were so insignificant, so gradual, that we were able to control them. Or so we thought. But one thing we underestimated was the power of the neural network. A million Geth thinking simultaneously created an inherently unstable matrix.
So the Geth share brain power?
Many of the Geth's logic systems were designed to work in concert with other nearby Geth. Basically, the more of them you have in the group, the smarter they are.
So there's some sort of group consciousness?
No, nothing like that. They cannot share sensory data or information. Their programming cannot handle that much simultaneous input. Each Geth maintains an individual awareness and identity. The neural network only operates on a process-based level. It's basically the synthetic equivalent of a subconscious. But when they're in close proximity, they can coordinate low-level functional processes, freeing up more capacity for original or independent thought.
What made them rebel?
As we built more and more Geth, their effective intelligence became more sophisticated, more abstract. One day, a Geth began to ask its Quarian overseer questions about the nature of its existence. Am I alive? Why am I here? What is my purpose?
Ajattelen siis olen. Cognito ergo sum.
I don't see what's so bad about those questions.
The Geth were created to engage in mundane, repetitive, or dangerous manual labor. That's fine for machines, but it won't satisfy a sentient being for long. The Geth were showing signs of rudimentary self-awareness and independent thought. If the Geth were intelligent, then we were essentially using them as slaves. It was inevitable the newly sentient Geth would rebel against their situation. We knew they would rise up against us, so we acted first. A general order went out across all Quarian-controlled systems to permanently deactivate all Geth. The Geth responded to this order violently.
Hey, you can't blame them for fighting for their survival.
We had no other choice. The Geth were already on the verge of revolution. By acting quickly, we had a chance to end the war before it began. The hope was that most of the Geth would still be little more than machines, incapable of organized resistance. But they had progressed much further than anyone anticipated. The war was long and bloody. Millions upon millions of Quarians died at their hands. In the end, we were forced to flee our own homeworld. We feared the Geth would pursue us, but they never came beyond the veil. Now we drift through space, exiled, searching for a way to reclaim what was once ours.
It's hard to feel sorry for you. Your ancestors tried to wipe out another species.
We made a mistake when we created the Geth in the first place. But we did not make a mistake when we went to war against them. If we had not acted, they would have wiped us out. They're a synthetic life form. They have no use for organics. None. Why do you think they cut themselves off from the rest of the galaxy? Why do you think they've killed every organic being who's ever tried to contact them?
Ei ole Sarenia.
What does that tell you? The Geth are not innocent victims in all this. They're the enemy. They want to destroy us. Not just the Quarians. All organic life. That's why they've joined up with Saren. And that's why we have to stop him.
Ja tämähän on toinen teema tässä pelisarjassa, että niin kuin onko tota noin niin aina niin toi. Kääntyykö aina niin kuin keinotekoinen elämä niin ihmisiä vastaan. No niin, nyt sitten tekemään jotain muuta, eli mieluummin räiskimään. Käydään katsomassa tota galaksin karttaa, niin mitä tehtäviä meillä on. No se yksi biottinen tehtävä, mikä oli vähän semmonen, muistaakseni, on ihan kohtuullisen tiukka taistelu alkutasoisella. Tällainen tää on.
Message coming in.
Mikäs toi unknown oli?
Patching it through.
Commander Shepard, my name is Nasana Dantius. I have a job for you. I can't say anymore in an unsecured communication. If you're interested in hearing my offer, meet me on the Citadel so we can talk in person.
Tää oli kakkosessa, tää tyyppi. Tää on yksi niistä sivutehtämistä, mitä vois itseensä tehdä. Nää kannattaa käydä läpi, kun niistä saa vähän rahaa ja sitä ei hirveesti ole. Joo, nää mä katoin jo. Eli, tässä on vaihtoehdot. Bring Down the Sky, se on vähän vaikeampi lisäosa. Noveria ja Feros, ne on niinkun isommat tehtävät. Mut mä sanoisin, että se Dantiuksen tehtävä vois nyt tällä kertaa tehdä, koska siis se on hyvä esimerkki, mikälaisia questeja tässä on. Ja mua kiinnostaa periaatteessa, mitä niinkun BioWare on tehnyt näille vanhoille tehtäville. Et onko ne saanut minkäänlaista polishia tai näin edespäin. Sitten se yksi kiipperi piti etsiä. Missähän se on? Mä olen mielestäni etsinyt ja löytänyt kuitenkin niin. Ainakin ne, mistä mä tiedän varmasti, missä ne on. Liara. Periaatteessa ei olisi pakko ottaa tuota talia mukaan, mutta silloin se hakkerointi niin kätevä, niin. saimme. Niin mulla on hirveä kasa pisteitä. Nyt tulee tää vastaan.
Rear Admiral Mihailovic, 5th Fleet.
Commander Shepard, SSV Normandy.
You don't know who I am.
Ensimmäinen virhe.
I command the 63rd Scout Flotilla. You and the Normandy were slated for my unit after shakedown. And the Council got their paws, claws, tentacles, whatever. They got them on our ship and you.
Captain Anderson made it clear to me that my assignment came from way up in the brass. They say jump, I say how high.
Remember that when I tell you to jump. I don't begrudge the politician's decision to throw you to the council. It's an opportunity. I do begrudge this over-designed piece of tin, though.
This ship has saved our lives a dozen times over.
An exaggeration. I've read your reports. This experiment diverted billions from our appropriations bills. For the same price, we could have had a heavy cruiser. But no. We had to make nice to the Turians, throw money at a co-developed boondoggle. I'm here to make an inspection, Commander. Normandy is an Alliance warship. I intend to see she's up to snuff.
Toinen virhe.
Normandy is an Alliance warship, but she's on loan to the Citadel. That means she's not in your chain of command.
I believe there's something wrong with my ears.
Did Kyllä. You just contradict me? Sillä oli iso tota noin niinku... komentosauva takapuolessa.
This ship is council property right now. So respectfully, please clear the gangway.
Have it your way, Commander. But expect me to file a report on this.
Se on Spectren alus.
With all this exploration of Prothean culture, this must be like a survey for you, Liara.
Our travels now are somewhat different from my normal excavations. I would prefer lengthier studies and fewer explosions.
Yes, most of the technology I had hoped to bring back to the flotilla has subsequently attempted to kill us.
Näin se on valitettavasti. Miksi kaikki päättää juuri tänään tulla minun kippuuni?
Kalisa Bensin in Al-Jalani, Westernland News. Would you answer a few questions for our viewers?
I'm not in the mood, Miss Al-Jalani.
People back home have heard a lot of wild stories about you, Commander. I can give you the chance to set the record straight. What do you say?
I don't have time to justify myself to your viewers. I have a galaxy to save. Excuse me.
Your choice, Shepard.
Tämä on myöskin niin sanotusti järkevä ratkaisu. Katsotaan nyt. Varastossa piti käydä. Sitten piti käydä vaan tuolla konsulaatti. Ah, täällä oli. No niin, täällä oli se viimeinen. Di. You up.
Hello, Commander.
Show me what you've got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Oh, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre? Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
No niin. myynti ei ollut niin hyvä kuin mitä aluksella oli myynnissä, niin en taida ottaa. Tuosta mulle tulikin mieleen, että mun täytyisi varmaan medikeelinkin määrää päivittää. Toi granaattien päivittäminen on sillä lailla, jos haluaa yhdestä tietystä sivutehtävästä päästä tosiaan niin kuin kympilän läpi, niin... Niin taas tää.
Hei! There are rumors on the extranet that you've been made the first human specter. That's incredible!
Right, Conrad. Right. A while back.
You remember me? Wow. Guys must try to talk to a lady like you all the time, but you remember me. That really means something. Hey, can I get your picture?
I don't have a problem with it, but why?
Are you kidding? Nobody will believe that I talked with the beautiful Commander Shepard unless I get a picture. Just hold up your gun. Perfect.
Joo.
Thanks again, Commander. I'm gonna hang this in my living room. My wife will love it.
Tää sitten ei. Olen hyvin epäilevä tuosta. Hyvät shaderit tähän kyllä pistetty, no kaasuefektejä ja muuta, mutta ei ole liikaa tätä peliä modernisoitu.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
Let me see what you have.
Oh, you will be pleased, I think. Very good things I have. You will see.
Medicaid upgrade. Otin kaksi saman tien, koska... Miksikäs ei?
Commander Shepard, I am Nasana Dantius. I see you got my message.
Ne on voimakkaammat meikit kuin aikaisemmin.
It sounded like you needed some help.
I do. My sister Dahlia is a crewman on the cargo vessel operating out beyond the fringes of the Traverse. Her ship was attacked by privateers. There were no reported survivors.
You want me to hunt down the people who killed her?
This is where it gets complicated. Last week, I received a message with her voice on it. Dahlia is alive. The rest of the crew was killed, but she was taken prisoner. The slavers demanded a huge ransom from me in exchange for returning her unharmed.
Why didn't the raiders kill Dahlia along with everyone else?
My sister probably told them who she was. My family's very wealthy, Shepard. They must have realized she was worth more to them alive.
You can't negotiate with criminals.
It's too late. I transferred the funds to the account they specified. Only they never released her. They haven't contacted me since. I've made a terrible mistake, Shepard. I'm a diplomatic emissary. By law, I'm required to report any attempted extortion to CSEC immediately. But I was afraid for Dahlia, so I just paid the ransom. Now she's still missing. And if anyone finds out what I did, I could end up in jail.
You got in over your head and you expect me to pull you out?
This is easy money for you, Shepard. I've already found her. You just need to bring her back. I tracked the ransom payment through several accounts. Eventually, it led to a small mercenary band operating out of the Artemis Tau cluster. I need you to go to the Merc base, take them out, and bring my sister back. You shall be well rewarded.
Don't worry. I'll bring your sister back.
Thank you, Shepard. I knew you were the right woman for the job. Come back and see me when the job is done.
No niin. Eli tällainen tarina. lehtiä. Okei.
Your biotic skill is extremely impressive, Dr. Tassoni. Is that typical among Asari?
While the Asari have natural biotic abilities, not all have the desire to learn to use their abilities effectively.
And the Asari are the most advanced race on the Council. I wonder if all Citadel races will eventually be natural biotics.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
No niin,
eli. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Mä oon kyllä tosi iloinen, että tässä on nopeutettu näitä hissien nopeutta. Ne oli aika hitaita kuitenkin.
Looking for supplies?
Siinä vanhassa versiossa.
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
Nyt tuli vähän säälättyä. No joo, näin voi käydä. Eli Artemis Tau.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Commander, Miss Algelani's story on you just aired.
Ei varmaan ollut hyvä juttu.
I don't blame you for blowing her off. She should have made a request through channels. I have PR people doing spin control, a little mimetic engineering, and people will forget about this in a week. Just wanted to let you know what the response was back home. I won't keep you any longer. Fifth Fleet out.
Niin se saattoi valittaa se amiraalikin saman tien. Niin. Artemis Tau. Se on muuten myöhemmissä peleissä huomattavasti kätevämpää, kun sä näet heti niin kuin tällaiselta näytöltä, että mitä questeja. Täällä on tarjollani. Kirjoituksia löytyy. Täällä ei ole mitään. Kaasua, komissaario Palmu. Eli Ja tässä on nyt sanottu, että tää on niinku helpompi ajaa, ja voisin sanoa, että joo, periaatteessa se pyrkii kääntymään tähän näin suuntaan, mihin mä tornia niinku osoitan. Mä tykkäisin pelkästään niinku yksinkertaisesti niin. Vaan niinku näppäimistöllä ohjata, mutta kaikkea ei voi saada. Useimmille ihmisille on varmaan todennäköisesti helpompaa tuota tää. Menee sinne, minne katsotaan. Mut tässä on nyt se, kun mä painan eteenpäin koko ajan nappia. Nyt se on tonne menossa, nyt mä katson tonne noin, niin sitten kun mä rupeen kääntymään, niin nää vaihtaa roolia nää napit. Riippuen siitä, että mihin mä katson tästä nää. Et siinä mielessä tää ei ole niinku sillai yksiselitteisesti yksinkertaisempi ajattava. Okei. Ja tää on niinku ehdottomasti sitä aikaa, kun tosiaan niin siihen aikaan, kun ei ollut mitään niinku hirveän tehokkaita laitteita ihmisillä, niin Matriarkan kirjoituksia. Olen kanssa joskus ne. No niin, nyt nimenomaan tosta mä puhuin. Eli mun selkärangasta tulee jotain komentoja ja nyt tulee ohjattua vähän ehkä tätä väärään suuntaan. Kiipeämiskyky on edelleen ihan äärimmäinen tällä laitteella näköjään. Hiiren kiihdytystä on kanssa tässä vähän ehkä edelleen havaittavissa. Tää ehkä liimautuu vähän tehokkaammin tohon vuoreen kiinni, mikä on sillä lailla ainakin, sanotaan nyt sillä lailla, kätevämpää, tai siis helpottaa pelaajaa. On kans tutkittavaa. Planeettojen grafiikat on parantunut. Ne oli ilmeisesti ottanut mallia, tai sitten ne oli lisensoinut noita modeja, mitä näihin oli tehty näihin peleihin. Jompikumpi täytyy arvostelua varten katsoa sitten. Tuolla on peissi. Et sillain niinku tää on hyvä. Tai siis saattaa jopa karvan verran välillä olla parempikin kuin ne modatut Mass Effectit. Tietysti ne ohjelmamoottorissa oli aika paljon vikaa, eli tää latausajat on huomattavasti nopeampia ja tää osaa nykyisestä käyttöjärjestelmästä toimia niin paremmin. Minkä takia näitä remakeja tehdään, että ne toimis niinku uusilla järjestelmillä kuitenkin sitten loppujen lopuksi. Ihan hiukkasen on ehkä painovoimaakin kasvatettu ja auto ei lentele ihan miten sattuu. Eikä tullut tuostakaan vahinkoa. Kaikkea ihmeellistä ihmiset pistää sisään ja muut olennut, niin noihin. avaruusluotaimiin piti sanomani. No niin, nyt varsinainen taistelutehtävä, eli tuonne pitää tunkeutua ja perinteiseen tapaan ampua kaikki. Yksi vaihtoehto on lähestyä tästä viereiseltä mäeltä, pääsee tuolla tykillä ampumaan. Tämä on tässä versiossa nyt niinku aika tehokas tämä Makon tykki. On ehkä vielä boostattu vähän sitä. Tai sitten se on vaan vähän jykevämpi tuo ääniefekti. Niin mä kuvittelen, että se on parempi. Joka tapauksessa tämä oli vanhassakin versiossa äärimmäisen tehokas ajoneuvo. Nyt tässä Legendary-pelimoodissa niin sä myös saat saman verran kokemusta Makolla tehdyistä tapoista kuin jalkasin. Koska osa pelaajista meni sillä, että ne joutui jalkautumaan turhaan. Jaha. Melkoinen killdozerihan tää on. Rexillä on... Jos on kommentteja tai ehdotuksia, mitä mun kannattaisi pelata, niin pistäkää tuonne chattiin tosiaan kommentteja ja muuta mukavaa. Niin mielelläni katsotaan. Kaveri halusi, että Renegadea vedän, mutta mä oon ehkä pelannut enemmänkin sillä, että mikä on niinku järke... Itse asiassa sanotaan niin, että vahinko, mutta... Coveria tää ei ota ihan niin tehokkaasti kuin myöhemmissä peleissä edelleenkään. Orjuuttaja. R6-kiväri on nyt kiva. Ja yllättävän tehokaskin. Joskus se ottaa ton suojan, mutta se on vähän sillai edelleenkin samalla tavalla niin kuin vaikeeta sen suojahaku alun perin. Täytyy sanoa, että tää nyt meni huomattavasti tehokkaammin kuin mitä niin kuin ajattelin. Että mikäs mulla on vaikeusaste muuten? Hardcore. Okei, 3 sekuntia aikaa. Noin. Mun ei tykkää olla 3. Noniin. Ja hirveä kasa muutakin rommua. DR on parempi. Jos se lifti alkaa heittää, niin toi duration bonus on ihan hyvä. Tätä mä mietin. Mä oon tykännyt tosta, mitä mä äsken käytin. Liarakin pärjää yllättävän hyvin tällä rynnäkkökiväärillä. Sen voisi tehdä tuolla noin, että tähtäimen, niin se saa vähän bonusta siihen, kun tämä muutos, mikä tässä on tullut, on se, että niin infiltraattori aikaisemmin, joo, pistoli ja kivääri, mutta ei rynnäkkökivääri. Eli kaikki, mitkä sammuit, niin valtelujana miinuksilla. Mutta niin tässä versiossa nyt niin ei enää ole sellaista ongelmaa, että niin kuin kaikki aseita voi käyttää, mutta sitten jos sä olet, sulla on esimerkiksi tarkkuuskiväri, totta kai sä oot vaan parempi siinä vahinkoja kaikkea kaikkeen muuta. Et siinä mielessä niin kuin helpotettu tätä peliä, ja sitten kun on tarkempi, niin enemmän osumia kohteessa, niin vastustajat tuntuu helpommilta. Mä ainakin itse ymmärtäisin sen näin. Ei ollut mitään kivaa täällä. Okei, dekryptio on liian pieni. Se olikin Nassanan sisare, joka johti näitä orjuuttajia. Eli tehtiin juuri sille tota noin niin kuin likasta työtä niin sanotusti. Tämä oli itse asiassa ihan hyvä muistutus sillä lailla. Hyvä muistutus pelaajalle, että tämmöstäkin voi käydä. Ei hirveästi kyllä jaksa juosta. Tossa oli. Tuohon on lisää tavaraa. Tätä löytyy kaikkea kivaa. Pitäisiköhän katsoa vielä uudestaan, että tuolla vasemmalla mä näin yhden paketin.